Good afternoon. Good afternoon. For our platform guests, HKT family, parents, community supporters, and to my graduation class members of 2019, I stand before you representing my classmates on a day we have been looking forward to for a very long time, graduation day. It is a distinct pleasure to recognize you today. We have worked hard to get to this point in our lives, and we have not done it without the love and support of our parents, other family members, faculty, and friends. We are overjoyed that you are here this day to help us celebrate. Your presence is proof that you are happy for us. Your presence is proof that you care. We have witnessed us develop into the people we are today. We have experienced challenges and victories, but here we are all, to all of you. We are eternally grateful.
Father, help us to not look more than fear to the changing in life. Rather, we are looking into it with full hope because that change arrives. You will lead us safely through all things because we are our very own. And we cannot stand it. You will carry us in your arms. With you, we shall not fear what may happen tomorrow, because you are the understanding Father, who cares for us today and who will care for us tomorrow and every day.
It is an honor for me to have the distinct opportunity to introduce our platform guest this afternoon. We have several representatives of Orangeburg Consolidated School District 4 and District Office. As I call your name, please stand and stay, remain standing. Superintendent Dr. Elena Williams, Orangeburg Consolidated School District 4, Mr. Joe Garvin, Orangeburg Consolidated School District 4 Chairman, Mr. Aaron Rod, our principal, Dr. Mark Dean, our assistant principal, Ms. Denise Grimes, and our guidance counselor, Ms. Sheila Elwood. Please give them a round of applause.
Mr. Garvin, on behalf of the faculty, staff, and district administration of Orangeburg Consolidated School District 4, we would like to present you with this plaque that reads, presented to Joseph P. Garvin, 27 years of service, 1992 to 2019, for outstanding commitment, dedication, and support to the citizens, faculty, and staff of Orangeburg Consolidated School District 4. Thank you. Ms. Tyler, on behalf of the faculty, staff, and administration of Orangeburg Consolidated School District 4, we would like to present you with this memento for representing us for 34 years, 1984 to 2018. Of the citizens, faculty, and staff of the Orangeburg Consolidated School District 4 community, and we know that you will continue to represent us well in the Orangeburg County School District. Thank you.
I'm fortunate to have had an opportunity to serve as principal for their preparation to provide experiences that positively impact their future lives. Speaking to you graduates at this time. Graduates, this is the moment you've been waiting for. One where you no longer have to go to school for 7+ hours daily, report to classes to the sound of bell, and adhere to policies such as dress code and cell phone use you may find restricted. However, many things don't show their value right away. For instance, chores I had as a youth such as shucking corn and snapping beans and hanging out clothes were not at the top of my list of things to do. They consumed the valuable time I had on after school or on Saturday to do other things. But as I continued to sit the chores throughout the years, I began to see the significance of what I was doing. I grew from the experience as one who learned from contributing to life's experiences for the benefit of others, taking pride in my work and being relied on to do a good job. The majority of things worth having appear after going through some stuff. are not having the value you would like to see or have right away. Thus, take some time to embrace your root and be cognizant of the fact that you're already experiencing value and worth with the process of growing, like I tell you, growing your brain and putting forth that constructive effort. Now listen to this last paragraph carefully, and then I'm going to close with this. I challenge you to not get caught up in the stigma that has evolved with your generation, which is one of entitlement, getting what I want right now, and valuing what you have to go through to get where you want to go. Please take some time to reflect on valuing the process, the experiences that lead to greatness or success. If a result has not yet appeared or did not come when you wanted it to, be happy with the opportunity you've had to grow through the process.
Challenge. The word often drips from my lips when difficult situations arise. It is a word that I've heard counselors, politicians, teachers, and even my own family utter. The mere definition, as defined by Webster's Dictionary, is very simple. It means to confront or defy boldly. In catastrophic times, people often ask, how long will a structure stand? Will it bend? Will it shake? Will the slightest breeze cause it to sway, even just a little? But the real question, my friends, is not how long will the structure stand, but how strong is your foundation?
That senior year did pass through like a whirlwind. Most of us was broke or broke our parents with all the senior duties, middle college fees, and all the extra costs of being a high school senior. Our senior year also came with many stressors that caused many breakdowns, many mental breakdowns. However, we were still able to win the battle against senior debt and mental breakdown to stand here in front of you as the senior class of 2019. We will carry many wonderful memories that will forever be with us from our high school years. We had struggles and fell a couple of times. We had to pick ourselves up, dust ourselves off, and start over. The important thing is that we made it. It came out as winners. We did it with each other's help and the encouragement and the support of everyone in here. I want to thank everyone from the custodians, cafeteria workers, bus drivers, teacher aides, teachers, school administrators, parents, and our families for everything you did.
Congratulations. Today is your day. You're off to great places. You're off on the way. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own and you know what you know. And you are the one who'll decide where to go. You'll look up and down the street, look them over with care. About some you'll say, I don't wish to go there. With your head full of brains and your shoes full of feet, you're too smart to go down a not so good street. And you may not find any you'll want to go down. In that case, of course, you'll head straight out of town. It's open up there, in the wide open air. Out there, things happen, and frequently do, to people as brainy and footsie as you. And when things start to happen, don't worry, don't stoop. Just go right along. You'll start happening too. Thank you.
Yeah.
Jakari Demetri Crawford. Alexis Therese Robinson. Devin Malik Robinson. Nyasia Mercedes Rowe. Ariel Marie Ryan. Ebony Prophet Jackson. Sorry about this. It's Ebony Janae Jackson. Okay, Jakari Demetri Crawford. Kayshawn Demonte Shuler.
future because of what we have achieved and will achieve. Graduation is not the end, but our beginning. God, we ask your almighty hands to be upon us, those who are graduating, our family and friends. Bless our lives from this day on with goodness and love. Help us stay true to our dreams, to our gifts wisely, and to walk into the future with faith, hope, and great love. This blessing, all blessings, we ask in